disinformation is really important when it comes to radicalization. I mean, if you're not really careful and you go online, you just want to find something out, be it just through a Google search or even, you know, worse, like places like YouTube where there's lots and lots of disinformation, it's very easy for you to go down a rabbit hole and end up with video after video on YouTube feeding you disinformation if you're not really skeptical and careful with the information that you're receiving. That can rapidly lead to you developing some radical ideas. And because the YouTube algorithm works in a way that you don't fully understand, you get video after video that just seems to strengthen and confirm those beliefs as you build them. In fact, it's another really dangerous aspect of the rise of populist politicians is that they seem to get away with saying and doing outrageous things now. And that sets a precedent for everyone else in the society, right? And if everyone feels like they can believe whatever they want to without worrying about factual evidence anymore, it kind of gives them the right to do whatever they want, right? So if I believe, for example, that people of another race or another sexual identity or whatever are subhuman, then I can, you know, easily justify something like discrimination or even genocide. And people feel like they can now believe things, say things that maybe 10 years ago they wouldn't have been, or they would have hesitated to say in public. You know, it's like, if he can say it, I can believe it. If he can say it, I can say it. You know, if you have leaders in the community that express those misinformed views. So the social norms are shifting. And of course, there are groups out there that want to see social division, and disinformation campaigns are really effective at achieving that.